So, how's everybody doing? Hopefully, doing well. So, I was watching a video by Celeste Headlee, and it was on ways to have a better conversation. So, in fact, the title of the video is 10 Ways to Have a Better Conversation. And although she's talking about human interaction, which is speaking and listening, I thought that a lot of her points were actually very applicable to the art of music itself or being a musician. Primarily taking a solo, but it could be playing solo guitar, playing into in a contextual type setting with other musicians. And she had, again, 10 ways to have a better conversation or basically better dialogue. I'm not going to go through all 10 of them. I thought a couple of them were actually very, very appropriate, like I said, in respects to being a musician. The first one was don't multitask. I think a lot of times when people are having a conversation and, they're looking at their phones, they're just multitasking. So they're not really concentrating on what's at hand. And I've seen this actually happen just in terms of the band setting. If you are playing your music and if you really want to reach the highest level, you have to be present. You have to be in the here and now. It's not about thinking about the problems that you have with your significant others. It's really about being present and being in that moment. So multitasking is a definitely a way for you to have a bad conversation. So I think that's actually very appropriate when it comes to musical interaction. Another thing that she had I thought was like very, very interesting, which was don't pontificate. And what she said about pontification is like really to speak opinions in a pompous way. If you've ever played in a contextual setting where you're playing with a musician that's very, very educated. They might have gone to conservatory, or they might have gone to great jazz school. They could have gone to Berklee. They could have gone to New England Conservatory. They could have gone to Juilliard. There's a tendency, not all of those players, but a bad player that's not going to have a good conversation or a good musical dialogue is going to be very pompous sometimes. It's just basically opinionated. They have their opinions. Okay, this is a 251. So based upon this being a 251, these are the scales that you need to play. This is how Miles wants you to play this piece. It could be, and so just people who react that way do not have a good conversation and do not have good solos. So I thought that was pretty appropriate. Just don't pontificate, So in addition to like don't multitask, don't be a pompous ass. Don't just be strictly adhering to the music theory that you learn at some great university. So the third one is that having a good conversation, I love this one, is not a promotional opportunity. Again, let me say that again. It's not a promotional opportunity. A lot of people take solos and they think it's all about them. So it's like talking and listening. And that we're gonna get to listening, which is the most important part. But it's not a promotional opportunity. You don't have to play everything you know when you take a solo, when you do a solo piece, or you're playing by yourself. So it's not an opportunity to show somebody, yes, I know that Locrian mode, I know the Dorian mode, I know the Aeolian mode, and this is, you don't have to be a genius and show everybody what you know. So it's not a promotional opportunity. And by the way, people who do come off that way, if you really love music and you're really about it, you get turned off by that if it becomes a promotional opportunity. I know I listen to artists like Bill Frisell because of their humility. They know a lot more, but the simplicity in the way that they're playing, it's very organic and earthy, and it's very good. So I like that. So don't make it a promotional opportunity. The last thing that she talked about was listening. Okay, and that's the most important part. So to have a good conversation is to basically listen and listen and listen and listen some more. It's not about you talking. And it's the same way to have a good musical conversation with your fellow musicians, with the audience, is you have to listen. I thought this was an interesting quote and I wrote it down, but it was true listening is setting aside of oneself. Okay? When you listen, you have to get away from your opinions and your way of thinking, because it's not about you. You have to go in and you have to be listening with the hopes that you have an opportunity to understand something. You don't listen so you can reply. So musicians, and speakers and people, when they're having a dialogue, that listen only so they can get their part in, but not really understand what's being said or not actively listening. So I thought that was very, very deep in terms of that. We talk about listening being a key functionality. So anyway, so a little offbeat type of video that I did, but hopefully you guys got something out of this, and have a great day. Thank you for watching.